Hello, church family. Only 3 days until Christmas. I pray that your hearts have been refreshed as you reflect on the goodness of God in sending his Son. In today's devotional, Sinclair Ferguson wrote of another prophecy fulfilled. This is in reference to what we spoke about yesterday in the devotion on the child pogrom. Now, a pogrom is an organized assault on a particular group of people. Bloody, evil Herod sent his soldiers to kill all the male babies 2 and under. Now that brings us to today. In Matthew 2, 17 through 18, it says, "Then was fulfilled what was spoken by the prophet Jeremiah. A voice was heard in Ramah, weeping and loud lamentation, Rachel weeping for her children. She refused to be comforted because they are no more." This is actually a quotation from Jeremiah 31, when the people of Judah are being deported to Babylon. What's even more amazing is that Jeremiah is referencing the death of Rachel, who was full of great sorrow because she would not see her children anymore after she is gone. What Matthew is doing here is pointing out that even in the midst of great sorrow, there is hope because God is faithful and he is powerful. The promise of the Messiah was to be fulfilled in spite of the powers of the world's best efforts to quench it. Nothing can overcome the work of our God, and he is able to fulfill his promises. I've recently had a squirrel problem at my house. Nora's room started to smell a little bit, and so we were wondering what was going on in the attic. It smelled like something was dead. So on a Friday night, I went up there, and I couldn't find anything. I found a bunch of squirrel poop. I didn't find anything in the insulation. I pulled everything back. Nothing. So we vacuumed up the squirrel poop, we cleaned it up, and then the next Tuesday, when I had some time, I went to Home Depot and I bought some new insulation just to replace the old stuff. I bought some chicken wire to put some wire up where the squirrel was getting in, and I bought some repellent. I was doing everything I could to help my daughter's room. I didn't want her to have to suffer in any way through the smell. So I go through the problem. I'm up on the ladder, up on the second story. I'm putting chicken wire up so that the squirrel doesn't get in. And I've been up there for about 2 hours probably working on this project. And right at the point of 2 hours, I've just gotten the chicken wire all up. What do you think comes flying out of the attic? Now, I'd already checked the attic. I'd made sure that there wasn't anything in there. But sure enough, that squirrel comes flying out of the attic. Of course, my first instinct is to grab it because I want to break its neck. I'm not that cold. But this thing's caused so many problems. I just want it to be over. But I slowly back down off the ladder so that there's no accidents. And then I chased the squirrel. Couldn't find the squirrel. At least now I know I can put the chicken wire back up and everything will be okay. Well, that night after dinner, I go up to replace the insulation. And I'm pulling back the insulation, and what do you know I find? I find a dead squirrel in my insulation. So there had been 2 squirrels. One was still alive, which I think we got out. And then a second one had been dead and just decaying up in our loft. Now, I got down to Nora and I said, "Nora, we found the problem. Your room isn't going to stink anymore." Now, in similar ways, I can promise, "Nora, I will take care of this problem." But there was points where I didn't know if my ability to take care of the problem was going to be enough. I needed something else to help me take care of that problem. You might be experiencing great sorrow this holiday season. And the holidays may remind you more of what you've lost than what you've found. But what Matthew and Jeremiah are telling us is that even in the midst of great sorrow, there is great hope. Now, just like the squirrel, I don't know if I have the ability to fulfill my promises. But God has the power, and he's faithful to fulfill his promises. Because even though the powers of this world attempt to thwart God's plan, the Messiah still came. God still overcame through Christ. And because Christ came, he has conquered death, and he has given us eternal hope. So even if you can't bear to think about the holidays, or maybe you know someone who can't, take heart, because Christ has conquered it all. So celebrate his arrival this week. Celebrate that he has overcome all of our suffering by becoming a man and going to the cross. Merry Christmas.